Hi, this is Ruby Wax, and congratulations to all the fixers for your award.
Hello, I'm Stacey Sunderland.
Hello, Stephen Fry here, wishing all you fixers extremely good luck.
Well done to all you fixers who are doing such an amazing job and making so many people happy.
You're an inspiration to us all.
Please welcome your host, Natalie Pinkham.
Today, we are celebrating the success of thousands of fixers throughout the country's ITV regions over the last year and finding out how their projects are changing lives.
I'm James Armstrong, I'm 18 and I'm from Newcastle. Our ITV Fixers project was about homelessness and looking at some of the unnecessary bureaucracy within the system, peer pressure, drugs and violence. I was homeless and I was so frustrated with the way the system was treating people and I just really wanted to express myself somehow, and the only way I could do it was with, you know, actors in a camera.
We're a group of people that have all experienced homelessness. With help of ITV Fixers, we have made the Stop Your Drama to highlight important issues within the homeless system and to show you, through drama scenes, what it's actually like to be another face in the crowd.
I can smell the cannabis from downstairs in the office!
We had a premiere which was in the Star and Shadow cinema, and we had loads of, you know, political people there, MPs, key decision makers who could possibly listen and make some sort of difference, you know. And also we've got into schools, colleges, and that's to show the young people what it's like to be homeless and show them the kind of support that they can get when they're homeless.
My name's Stacey Campbell, I'm 24 years old and I'm from Sunderland. My Fixers project was Creative Against Cancer. I made a book of portrait drawings and stories of people who had been affected by cancer to raise money for Cancer Research UK.
The reason I'm doing this project really was my granddad. In July 2009, we lost him to cancer, and we'd only known he had cancer for about 3 weeks before he died. So that was like a huge loss because the whole family are really close to him.
I'm really pleased with what the project's achieved and what it's still got to achieve. The book only went on sale yesterday and we've raised nearly £300 already.
Describe to us the difference that this project's made to you individually.
It's kind of saved my life, to be honest with you. I mean, if it wasn't for this project, I kind of would have went down a complete different path. It's also, you know, it's given us an outlet to express myself, and it's given us a platform to say what I really want to say and to have people that listen to us, you know. Otherwise, I would express myself through self-destruction drugs.
It's been a really good day. There's been some lovely projects, and I was really impressed with a lot of the musical acts, which were also the ITV Fixer people. And I actually thought they were all just professionals kind of that have come in. I know you ain't gonna let
this go. It's quite humbling to come along and listen to all of these remarkable people are doing up and down the country.
To see those kids express themselves, say, this is what I want to do. I want to do something for my community. There's too many drugs, there's too many knife crimes. There's not enough this, there's not enough that. They're addressing the issues. And for me, that's fantastic.